And today, this is it, guys. Nag-announce na si Prime Minister Fumio Kishida ng mga mangyayari sa October. Alamin natin sa video na to kung interested kayong pumunta dito sa Japan. Ito na yung news na hinihintay natin. Halos isang taon na, guys, kaya simulan na natin. Hi, guys! This is Alan. Welcome back to this channel, Gaijin World! So, ayan, guys. Japan to start nationwide travel discount program on October 11 dahil Japanese government will start its planned nationwide travel discount program October 11, Prime Minister Fumio Kishida said Thursday. Dahil nga, guys, ay magbubukas na uli ang border ng Japan. The government will also launch a discount program to support entertainment and other events on October 11, Kishida told a news conference during his trip to New York. He expressed a wish to revitalize its economy hurt by the novel coronavirus crisis through the two programs following the recent decrease in new COVID-19 cases. Kishida also announced plans to ease the country's COVID-19 border measures October 11 by scrapping the daily cap on arrivals from abroad, accepting independent tourists, and waiving visa requirements for short-term stays. He said he will give detailed instruction to formulate a comprehensive package of economic measures on September 30. O diba, ibig sabihin ay papayagan na makapasok dito yung mga independent tourists. So hindi na sila kailangan sumali sa isang package tour, pumunta sa isang travel agency at mag-avail ng package tour. Starting October 11 ay pwede na kayong magbakasyon dito as individual tourist. At tatanggalin na nga daw yung 50,000 daily cap. So alamin natin yung news na yan. Ito yung news. So according sa Kyodo News, Japan to remove daily 50,000 entry cap on October 11. According to Prime Minister Fumio Kishida, Japan will remove its cap on daily arrivals on October 11 as part of its easing of COVID-19 border controls, Prime Minister Fumio Kishida said on Thursday at a news conference on the sidelines of the UN General Assembly in New York. Kishida said that in addition to lifting the daily cap currently at 50,000, Japan will resume visa-free individual trips to the country on the same day. Japan's antivirus measures have been criticized at home and abroad for being too stringent. Pero guys, i-expect ninyo yung sinasabi nilang visa-free country ay hindi kasama ang Philippines dyan for sure. Dahil kasama lang dyan yung mga United States, Canada at yung mga ibang dati nang may free visa country. So parang mangyayari, guys, ay babalik lang yung situation ng pagpapapasok dito ng mga foreigners sa Japan bago mag-pandemic. So ibabalik lang nila yung ganoong condition. Pero syempre dahil nga sa para ma-avoid yung pagkalat ng coronavirus kahit mababa na yung cases ay meron pa rin niyang mga susunding mga protocols na i-announce na sa September 30, kaya abangan din natin yan. So according naman sa Japan Times, Japan to reopen to independent travelers and lift daily arrival caps according to Prime Minister Fumio Kishida. Japan will allow visa-free independent tourism and abolish a daily arrival cap as of October 11, Prime Minister Fumio Kishida said Thursday, marking a major policy shift after nearly 2.5 years of strict COVID-19 restrictions. The government will also launch a nationwide travel discount program, yung nabalita nga natin kanina, which had been shelved due to the spread of the coronavirus infection. So yung mga nakakaalala ng go-to travel discount, malamang ito yung i-resume na nila by October 11. Kishida made the long-awaited announcement during his visit to New York for the UN General Assembly. Sabi niya, "I hope many people will utilize it," Kishida said at a news conference. "I want to support the travel, entertainment, and other industries that have been struggling during the coronavirus pandemic. We are extremely happy to see the long-awaited easing of restriction," Shinichi Inoue, president of All Nippon Airways, the core unit of ANA Holdings, told reporters Friday. "We will increase flights from the end of October to welcome customers from abroad. The economic impact of inbound travelers before the COVID-19 pandemic is said to be roughly 5 trillion yen, and we are pinning great hopes that there will be economic effects of similar size," Inoue said, adding that the yen's sharp decline against the dollar will definitely serve as an incentive for foreign people to come to Japan. So alam naman natin, nabalita rin natin kahapon na sobrang bagsak din ang Japanese yen. Against dollar, $1 is to 144 ata or 145 yen na. And then yung peso naman ay nasa 58 per dollar. So ibig sabihin nun guys, kung magta-travel kayo dito at meron kayong dollar, mas marami kayong mapapapalit na Japanese yen na magagamit ninyo sa mga pamimili ninyo ng mga souvenirs, anime figures, mga travel discounts, at kung ano-ano pa. Marami kayong mga mapaggagamitan niyan dito. He said it will lead to stimulating regional economies as well as there are many people who want to travel to different areas of Japan. Japan Airlines also welcomed the move, saying in a statement that the company will fully prepare to welcome visitors and contribute to revitalizing the Japanese economy. Japan has been allowing tourists since June, starting with people on guided tours. On September 7, the government allowed those on non-guided tours who had booked their flights and hotels through registered travel agencies. But those measures have been unpopular with many foreign tourists who want greater freedom during their trips. Tourists will need to be vaccinated 3 times or submit a negative COVID-19 test result ahead of their trip, Kyodo News reported, citing government sources. A nationwide domestic travel program offering discounts for travel, entry to theme parks, and for sporting events and concerts is also set to start on October 11. People who have been vaccinated 3 times or submit a negative test result will be eligible for the discounts, according to the report. The program offers financial assistance of up to 11,000 yen or $77 per person for one night stay. So hindi na yun masama guys kung mag-a-avail kayo ng travel discount pag kayo ay magta-travel dito sa Japan. Magandang offer na yan. The moves will be welcomed by the nation's tourism sector, which has been hit hard by the pandemic. So yun guys, anong masasabi ninyo dito sa news na ito? Magandang balita. Breaking news to ngayon guys. October 11, starting October 11, ay papayagan ng makapasok dito yung mga free or yung mga visa-free countries at yung mga independent tourists na hindi na kailangang mag-avail ng package tour at pwede nang dumiretso mag-travel dito as Japanese tourists. So magandang balita yun guys. Kung magandang balita, mag-like na kayo at mag-share. At mag-comment na din kayo kung meron kayo mga opinions related sa balitang to. At kung nagustuhan nyo nga, share nyo na rin to sa mga naghihintay ng travel update related sa travel ban dito sa Japan. Thank you so much for watching. Abangan natin yung mga susunod pang announcement dahil kinoconstruct pa nila yung magiging flow o yung protocol ng pagpasok dito ng mga individual tourists, visa-free countries. Well, unfortunately, I think hindi kasama yung Philippines dyan. Pero at least pwede na yung independent tourists. So kailangan pa rin natin kumuha ng visa bago tayo makapasok dito as a Filipino tourist sa Japan. Yan. Thank you so much again for watching. Kung nagustuhan nyo, like, share, and subscribe. Kung nakasubscribe ka na, thank you so much for watching. At kung hindi ka pa nakasubscribe, mag-subscribe ka na at i-hit mo yung notification bell para lagi kang updated sa aming mga susunod pang i-upload ng mga videos. At sa mga interested sa ibang mga topics namin related sa pamumuhay dito sa Japan at sa investing, check nyo aming YouTube homepage. Puntahan nyo yung playlist dahil marami kaming playlist dyan na makakatulong sa inyong pamumuhay dito sa Japan. Thank you so much again for watching. This is Alan and I will see you on our next video. Huwag nyong kalimutang i-check yung mga videos na lalabas ngayon dito sa screen. Bye!